Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Luke Swinkles, and welcome back to How to Compose Classical Music for Dummies. This is lesson 13, and today I would like to talk about the autoclav and about inversions, but not before we will revisit last week's topic. Last week I reintroduced a new scale, the harmonic minor scale, which is a minor scale where we sharpen the seventh note, and there is a difference in resolution in the 5-1 progression between the natural minor scale and the harmonic minor scale. The harmonic minor scale, the resolution is much stronger because it resolves with a half step instead of a whole step. We also learned the major sixth and the perfect fifth interval with our ear training. So let's just practice. Can you make the G harmonic minor scale using the circle of fifths and the knowledge that it is a minor scale where we sharpen the seventh note? And I would like for you to grab some pen and paper and pause the video, do it for yourself first, because by doing more exercises yourself, you will learn things easier. So harmonic minor, well, first the major. Major has one sharp, which is F sharp, so G major will be G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp, G. To make it the harmonic minor scale, we have to flatten the third and sixth note. So B becomes B flat and E becomes E flat. G harmonic minor is G, A, B flat, C, D, E flat, F sharp, G. You can also first make the G natural minor scale, G, A, B flat, C, D, E flat, F, G, and then sharpen the seventh note. So right now, the autoclav. There is just one instrument in the orchestra that makes life a bit difficult. As you can see in this example, the viola has a different clef than all the other instruments. All instruments are okay. Most of the time, all instruments are G clef or F clef, although the cello can also have an autoclav, but the viola always has an autoclav. Also the alto in a choir. And so we need to learn again how to read this clef. And this clef indicates the C. The middle of the clef on the third line, we have a C. So one note above C will be D, E, F, G. And you can remember it by the sentence, "Gray birds do fly." It's a really easy sentence to remember what notes are where. And the gray birds do fly, it's between the lines, not on the line, but between lines. G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A. So can you name these nine notes in autoclav? And always look first for clef and key signature. We have three flats. We have B flat, E flat, A flat. You can again pause the video if you want to do it for yourself. So the first note is the G. The second note is the C, because it's the third line, it's the C. Then we have the D. We have a C sharp. This is an accidental. In a previous class, I mentioned accidentals. This note is the B flat, A flat, and this is a C sharp again, because the accidentals are for the remaining of the measure. And in the next measure, this C sharp is again a C natural, because it's the next measure. And the last note is an E flat. And here are the answers given. G, C, D, C sharp, B flat, A flat, C sharp, C natural, and E flat. It's just another clef, really easy probably. But if you want to write something for viola, you need to know how to read the autoclav. In the course, I will not mention the clef whatsoever, but just again, if you want to write something for autoclav, or if you want to compose something for a choir, you need to know how to be able to read it. So now, inversions, and this is important. Okay, so, and this is has to do with chords. So as you know, A major, minor, and diminished chord have all three notes. And in the previous lessons, the chords were in root position. Root position means that the root is the lowest notes. So root position means that the lowest note, C, it is C major, it is F major, F is the lowest note. This is G major, G is the lowest note. C major, C is the lowest note. It's in root position. You can, if you want to identify in what kind of chord it is, we always looked at the bottom note first. This is a G, so you would know it is G major, G minor, or G diminished. But we can also change the order of the notes, and this is where first and second inversions comes in. So this is a C major chord because we have C, E, and G, but this is also a C major chord because E, G, C are the same notes, and G, C, and E are also the same notes. First inversion, there is one note above. Second inversion, there are two notes above. And if you want to know what chord it is, the root note is always the note above the gap. So you see that these two notes are together and one is alone. There is a gap between the first and the second and third note. The note above the gap, this is C. So you would know this is C major, C minor, or C diminished. And now you can look for all the notes. So we have C, E, and G. This means we have a C major chord. And that is also for the second inversion, where we have two notes above. Above the gap is the C. So, some exercises. And I will do the first one myself to clarify it a bit more. Can you name these notes? And they can be major, minor, or diminished. Can you also name the inversions or root position? So the first I will do myself. So above the gap is D. So this is D major, D minor, or D diminished. So we take a look at circle of fifths. D major has 1, 2 sharps, F sharp and C sharp. And I see an F natural. So D, F, A, 1, 3, 5. This is D minor. And it is in second inversion. Why? Because above the gap are two notes. Two notes, second inversion. Now I would like for you to do the remaining five chords. Can you name what chords they are? And can you tell me in what inversions they are in? So the second note, you can also pause the video again if you want to. The second chord is in root position. All the notes are together. So it is F major, F minor, or F diminished. So F major has 1 flat, which is B flat. So F, A, and C are 3 notes that are on F major scale. So the second chord is F major. The third chord. The third chord, we see a gap. Above the gap is the B. So this is B major, B minor, or B diminished. B, D, F. So B has a lot of sharps. F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp, and A sharp. And we see an D natural instead of a D sharp, and also an F natural instead of an F sharp. So that would mean that the third note and the fifth note is flattened. 1, flat 3, flat 5 means this is B diminished in second inversion, because above the gap we have two notes, second inversion. The third is also second inversion. Above the gap is an E. We have an E, G, B. And this is E minor, because E major would have an G sharp. We see a G natural. E major would have F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp, and the G sharp we don't see. That is flattened to a G natural. 1, flat 3, 5 means the fourth chord is E minor in second inversion. the fifth chord, E flat, G, B flat. It's in root position because we don't see a gap, which means it is E flat major, E flat minor, or E flat diminished. Well, let's see. E flat major would have 1, 2, 3 flats, which is B flat, E flat, A flat. And we see the E flat is in the scale G, B. All the three notes are in the E flat major scale, which means the fifth chord is a E major, is E flat major, I'm sorry, in root position. And the last, we see a gap this time, and above the gap is the note B. So it will be B major, B minor, or B diminished. So B major has, again, a lot of sharps. F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, D sharp, A sharp. And we see the F sharp and also the D sharp. So this is B major in first inversion, because above the gap we see one note, first inversion. And that is how inversions work. And these were again the correct answer. D minor in second inversion, F major in root position, B diminished in second inversion, E minor in second inversion, E flat major in root position, and B major in first inversion. And when we are going to compose, it is needed for good voice leading. And voice leading is something we will talk about in a future class, in a future lesson. But it is, I wanted to introduce inversions first. It is not really that difficult, but you just need to understand that we can put the notes in any order, C major, C, E, G, no matter what order we shuffle them, we will always get C major, and that is with inversions. So that actually already was this lesson. It was an incredibly short lesson, but this was actually everything I had to say. I just don't want to fill in time. Just to fill in time, we talked about alto clef for the viola or for the alto voice in the choir, and on triads and inversions. Next lesson will be all about ear training, because ear training is incredibly important, especially when we are going to compose ourselves at the end of this, in the end of the course. And I will invite you to the next lesson, which will be a bit of a longer lesson, I promise, on how to compose classical music for dummies.